On this episode of DeWalt Flexvolt Tool Repairs, we're going to show you how to replace the module and stator assembly, or in other words, the switch and motor field, on this DCS577 cordless worm drive saw. First, we'll talk a little about the saw, then we'll open it up and show you how to do the replacement. Is your saw experiencing intermittent or decreased power? What about sparks or smoke? That's not supposed to happen. If you're having power problems, check the battery first. Does it show a charge on the indicator light? Have you tried another battery? If you're certain your battery's in good shape, there could be a problem with your on-off switch, or with the control module that regulates power between the Flexvolt battery and the motor, or there could be a problem with the motor field itself. We would usually go into diagnostics to determine where the problem is occurring, but because it can be hard to tell exactly where the problem's coming from, DeWalt sells all three of these as one piece. Replacing the switch and field is a simple process anyone can do at home using OEM DeWalt parts from mmToolParts.com. If you think you're up for the challenge, grab your toolbox and follow along with me as I pull off the housing and replace this motor field. The housing is attached using several T15 and T25 torque screws. I'll remove those, leaving these two in the middle. At this point, the housing should slide free from the saw body. Here we can see the on-off switch, control module, and field or stator. To remove these, we'll have to remove the battery cage as well. When removing the rest of the battery cage, pay attention to the control module. These fit into the cage, and there's a little spring. You'll want to take note of that and how it was set so that you can replace it. Underneath the battery cage is this white or clear piece of plastic that's holding the wiring down. You'll want to remove this, and then we can pull out the field. The stator is held on by these three T20 torque screws. And it's also magnetized to the rotator, so to get it off, I'll remove these screws and then wedge a flathead screwdriver in there to pry it out. With everything removed, we can see the rotator. These rarely fail, so it's not likely yours is bad, but while you're in here, it's a good idea to check for any damage. Look for burned areas on the rotator. If it is failing, it will be visually obvious. It could also have a bad bearing, so give it a spin to feel for resistance. If it looks good, we can start reinstallation of the new module and stator assembly from mmToolParts.com. Start by installing the stator and line up the control module and wiring so the housing goes back together securely. Make sure the trigger lock, wiring, spring, and battery cage are all set in place before replacing the housing. That's it! You've just performed open surgery on your cordless worm drive saw. Now it's time to put the battery in and see if it's working. If you have anything to add to what we covered, or if you have any questions, chances are you're not the only one. So leave a comment for us below. And don't forget to like us, share us, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, where we have hundreds of how-to videos just like this one. Good luck with your repair. See you next time.